put up. You probably heard it from the other room. But we're looking at, like, things, you know, like, put up something, you know, kind of look behind the scenes a little bit. And as I said before, this track, the more I looked at it, the more I listened to it, the more I realized it was a perfect candidate. Because it's not perfect. So there's so many aspects to this song, to the loops, to how they fall, that are just wrong. Okay? Not wrong, but they're not in time. They're not snapped to the grid. They're not part of logic. They're not. This was old school days where you had an MPC and you would wild sync it, maybe put a couple of tracks down in sync, and then the rest of it you would just hand put in. Just boom, there it is. Oh, boom, there it is. So it was all performance. So again, no snap to the grid. It was in time, as close as it would be in terms of hitting it on the downbeat. But the thing that's, again, if the Simpty worked, but sometimes it did, sometimes it didn't. But the thing that's so interesting is to listen to the pieces of this song and how when they're out of balance, it's screwed up. When it's in balance, it was number one for 12 weeks. So it's so crazy. So again, the song is Jump by Kriss Kross. And Jermaine was just up a few weeks ago with Joey. And again, had even forgot that, oh yeah, there's a Schoolie D loop on here.
There's a Cypress Hill loop on here. There's a Humpty Hump loop. There's the three times dope loop.
And again, the main loop of this track is pretty obvious.
See, I don't know if you guys can tell what this is. Who's the group? What group is this?
You might recognize this.
Okay. Obviously, I told the story, but that's the Jackson 5. And when this record came out, Motown recognized it was the Jackson 5. And they called up and said, of course, the record is it's one of the top 40 biggest records of all time. So they called and said, will you use the Jackson 5 and we want money? And I said, I didn't use the Jackson 5. And they said, yes, you did. I said, no, I didn't. That's not the Jackson 5. And they're like, okay, well, then we're going to subpoena you and the tapes, and you're going to prove it's not the Jackson 5. I said, you name the date and the time, I will play you the material and prove to you it was not the Jackson 5. Because it's not. This is just a loop that sounds a lot like the Jackson 5. So so I'm a good poker player, but I could have easily proved that it wasn't the Jackson 5, but I didn't have to. So
is it the Jackson 5?
No.
It
just sounds a lot like it.
See, this was back in the day when, like, Jermaine was, like, 17 years old and didn't realize you got to get clearances on shit.
On that one? Yeah. There is guitar on
there?
You hear the
little thing? That's, Cypress Hill. This is Cypress Hill.
Kill him.
Fancy, ooh, look, it's all listed. It's a crayon jump on a piece of crap reel, you know? Because again, when we were working on this, it was like, oh yeah, jump. Yeah, it's, you know, okay, it's all right. It's pretty good, I think. But my favorite, two whole tracks of the multi-track that are dedicated just to this.
I love that record.
That's it. Two whole tracks. But that's how the song starts. This sample is.
Jump!
It's truncated.
Jump! Jump! Jump!
What makes it work? In the final mix, you've got, again, one very young Jermaine Dupri doing his own performance of it, all in real time, no samples.
Jump! 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 Jump!
Jump! Jump! Jump! Jump! Jump! Jump! Jump!
Yes. The bass. It's a DX7 sample that Joey actually played on the MPC.
Because the head of A&R at Columbia Records, David Kahn, said it had to have a bass on it. So it was like, okay.
But it didn't have a bass. And again, the first time David Kahn heard this song, he had four words. I fucking hate it. Four words. Right then, we should have known it was going to be a smash.
Okay, another true story. Honest to God, true story. It's A&R Tuesday up at Columbia Records. And we're sitting there, and Donnie comes in.
Donnie Einer,
who's the president of Columbia, blasts in and goes, "There's not one fucking hit on this record." And he throws it down on the desk, and he walks out. The miseducation of Lauren. Honest to God, true story.
Yeah. Yeah, so sometimes...
No further questions, Your Honor.
Sometimes those guys just don't hear it. And sometimes neither do we. Because, I mean...
Should have been tire salesman.
Yeah, you know? But, again, it just goes to show you that, you know, when you look at the guys who are the legends in this industry, and like what... Okay, Clive Davis comes to mind.
Calm it down.
But the thing is, here is a guy that is known to be, you know, he touches the stars and they turn into gold. The guy has had less than a 20% success rate. Now, that's unbelievable. It's unbelievable. Less than 20%. If he was a baseball player, he'd be in the minor leagues. You know? But again,
his hits were multi.
It just goes to show you that it's such a creative. It's you know, you don't know. How do you know? You something moves you. You go with it, and all of us in this room have had our favorite records of all time that no one has ever heard, and yet some things you just go, how the hell did that ever make it? You know, past Jump Street, and boom, you know, it's happening.
It's dumb shit luck.
Well, a lot of times it is.
Jump! 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 Jump!
Jump! Jump! Not having anything.
Jump! Jump!
Jump!
Again, throughout the song, these guys are arguing with Jermaine Dupri, all on the track.
Don't try to compare us to another bad little fad. I'm the Mac and I'm bad, giving something that you never had. I make your bump, bump, wiggle and shake your rump, cause I be kicking the butt, but that makes you wanna jump. How high, real high, cause I'm just a fly. A young, lovable, huggable type of guy. And everything is to the back with a little slack, cause inside out, it's wiggin' and wiggin' and wiggin' and
whack.
I come stumbling with something pumping to keep you jumping. R&B, rapping, bull crap, it's what I'm dumb. Ain't nothing something, cause we all act. So when they act,
seamlessly work with each other. There is definitely like going down a flight of stairs dizzy.
I must up knock it. I love it when a girl is like chalk it. The DAWDYMAC. Yeah, you.
Holy D, Saturday night.
Making some way to 6 step back. They try to step to the Mac, then they got checked. Is that coincidental?
Act like you know it, don't be claiming that it's mental.
Two good kids with a flow you ain't never heard. Ain't nothing fake, you can understand every word. As you listen to the Mac, dad'll make ya
jump.
A daddy Mac will make ya Kriss Kross will make ya. Uh-huh.
Come on, man. No, I want to be smooth, man. No, see, man.
All over the track. Again, Chris, like, argue with Jermaine that it's not good enough and blah, blah, blah. And Jermaine's like, oh, it's fine, you know. But, again, these guys, again, the story of how these guys got signed, but Jermaine found these kids in a mall, okay? They went to a record signing. And he saw them waiting in line. It was for, was it?
It was ABC. Another ABC. Band Creation was there.
And these kids are in line, and Jermaine's like, wow, you guys rap? No. What's your name? Kriss Kelly, Kriss Smith. Kriss Kross. Now, at the time, Jermaine used to wear his clothes backwards. It was just like, you know, his thing, I wear his clothes backwards. Okay. So he sees the two kids, and he says, wow, you want to? Yeah. You want to come to my house tomorrow? I'll write some jams.
Yeah.
The next day, they go to Jermaine's house.
No, the last two songs that Jermaine wrote was Jump and Warm It Up, Chris, by the way.
On the thing.
Yeah, they were the last two songs.
They were the last two.
Yeah.
But they went back to his place. They wrote I Missed the Bus.
They wrote everything, but we were going to do an EP. And it was like, because they had a song called Little Boys in the Hood. And we wanted to kind of make this the point of like, you know, what is a 12-year-old kid growing up on the south side of Atlanta? What future is he going to have? And that, you know, so and that was the focus. And it was like, well, instead of an EP, let's do an album. So it's like, so we need a couple more songs. And the last two songs that Jermaine came up with was Jump and Warm It Up, Chris,
which was the second single.
And to this day, I'm working with Jermaine right now. And it's like, we wait for the last two songs that we do because we know the last two songs are going to be the best ones. And literally, I was down in Atlanta with him last week. Doing, and these are the last two records we're doing, and we're thrilled because it's the last two. We know they're going to be the good ones. So, you know, this is kind of a superstition, you know.
Yeah. But, they weren't rappers, so they came up, we brought them up here. So we were, Jermaine did all of the rhymes. He rewrote them, he created them, he performed them all. So we spent hours and hours and hours and hours and hours getting the kids to learn each line, each sentence. And it'd be like, Jermaine would be like, I'm the Miggity Miggity Mac. The kid, I'm the Miggity, no, I'm the Miggity Miggity Mac. I'm the Miggity, no, I'm the Miggity Miggity Mac. I'm the Miggity, no, I'm the Miggity. Time and time and time. Just like, but to their credit, they learned how to become Kriss Kross. They learned how to do it. They were on tour with Michael Jackson. For instance,
people don't realize. Okay, the first record sold like 10 million copies worldwide. Second record sold 2 million copies. Third record sold 1.5 million copies. And then
actually, the second sold almost 4.
Well, I forget. I mean, I know U.S. had sold a couple. I mean, worldwide. So in terms of like, you know, when you think of them as a one hit wonder, believe it or not, they had 3 multi platinum records, to their credit.
But the crazy thing about how stuff falls, the record was out and it, you know, it was doing okay, a little regional activity, blah blah blah. Wasn't going crazy, but the kids were up. We were doing some remixes, some remix stuff with Super Cat and some other people, and Don DeVito, who's the head of marketing for promotion for Sony, called and said, "Are those kids up? Are they hanging?" I was like, "Yeah." Well, we just got a call. There was a popular television show on Sunday night called Living Color. Mm. Jim Carrey got his start there. And he was like, we've got 1:37 of the end of the show. And they would like to fill it. And we thought maybe the kids could do that jump song. And then during the credits. Mm-hmm. Sure. Okay. Well, we brought them up to New York. They did their thing, you know. There was a bunch of people running around the track. They did the lip sync thing. The show ran, the last 1:37, they did Jump, the credits rolled. The next day,